بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير. Just review the rules that we have learned already before we start exercise number three, because we know that we have to do the exercises based on the same pattern, on the same rule. So that's why it's better to have a look at the rules once more, inshallah, and then we will do the exercises. We have seen that there are different types of exception. The first one that we have learned is tamun, and tamun means that mustathna minhu is mentioned. That's why it is called tamun. Ja'at-tullabu kulluhum illa hamidan. All the students came except Hamid, so we know that at-tullabu is mustathna minhu. And mufarragun is where mustathna minhu is not mentioned. So that's the major difference between these two. Mufarragun, when mustathna minhu is not mentioned. And we know that the main adatul istithna is illa. And the noun that comes before illa is mustathna minhu. And the noun that comes after illa is mustathna. So here, mustathna minhu is mentioned when we talk about tamun. And when we talk about mufarragun, then mustathna minhu is not mentioned. So that's the biggest difference between these two. Then when a sentence or a kalam is tamun, it can be muttasilun and it could be munqatiun. Muttasilun means mustathna is of the same kind as mustathna minhu. So mustathna and mustathna minhu are of the same kind. And munqatiun, as it is clear from the name, mustathna is of a different kind from mustathna minhu, yani it is disconnected from mustathna minhu. In other words, whatever comes before illa, it is disconnected from that. And then we have muttasilun, and after that we have mujabun. And mujabun means that the sentence is affirmative. Simply it is affirmative. And when we say ghayru mujab, that means the sentence is negative, prohibitive, or interrogative. And here, if we see that if a speech or a kalam is tamun, and it is tamun, muttasilun, and mujabun, then it will always be, mustathna will always be mansub. So it should be tamun, muttasilun, and mujabun. And if it is mufarragun, then mufarragun means the mustathna will depend on, as if we remove illa, and it will depend on the irab of the noun that comes before it. So it's as if illa does not exist. So when you remove it, after that, whatever the possibility is there, then that will be the irab of mufarragun. Munqatiun is always mansub. So two types of mustathna are always mansub. Number one, when it is tamun, muttasilun, and mujabun. And number two, when it is munqatiun. If it is tamun, muttasilun, and ghayru mujab, then there are two possibilities, that it can be al-mustathna can be mansub, or it can be the same as mustathna minhu. So there are two possibilities. Number one, it can be mansub. And number two, it can be the same as it is like mustathna minhu. Or in other words, we can say that this is the badal of mustathna minhu. It is a substitute from mustathna minhu. Alright, استخرج من الدرس ما ورد فيه من أمثلة الاستثناء واذكر نوع كل واحد منها وإعرابه. So what we have to do, we have to extract the examples of استثناء, and then we have to mention the type of each kind of them and also the case endings. And alhamdulillah, we have done that in detail when we did the lesson. So I'm sure inshallah you know this already, and if you need to know more about it, you can always refer back to the lesson. عين المستثنى والمستثنى منه فيما يأتي. Now we have to specify the مستثنى and مستثنى منه. واذكر نوع الاستثناء في كل مثال, and then we have to mention the type of استثناء in each and every example. The first one is the verse of the Quran. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق. And do not say anything about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except for what is truth, and not say about Allah but the truth. Yes, so al-haqqa is mansub over here. All right. So, وَلَا تَقُولُ. So, first of all, the easiest thing we have to see is this mujab or غَيْرُ mujab. The kalam is mujab or غَيْرُ mujab. غَيْرُ mujab. Excellent. So, when it is غَيْرُ mujab, then we know that مُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ, there is a possibility that it can be mansub and it can be marfu. And as we know that in the Quran, the irab and the case endings are always there. So alhamdulillah, we don't need to bother about that. The only thing that we need to focus on is, like, whatever we have learned, we just try to implement it and make sure that whatever we have learned is right and we know how exactly it works. That's only for our own knowledge. Whereas we know that all the rules of the grammar are taken from the Quran. So we don't really have to bother about the case endings because it will always be there. But it will definitely help us to know our own knowledge, our own understanding of the rules, and also our own understanding of the Arabic language. Okay, so it's غَيْرُ mujab. And number two, is it tamun or mufarragun? وَلَا تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ. So do we have مُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ over here? It's not mentioned. So that's why it is مُفَرَّغٌ. So whenever we know that whenever مُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ is not mentioned, it is مُفَرَّغٌ. And it is مَرْفُوعٌ عَلَى أَنَّهُ مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ. And it is مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ of what? Of لَا تَقُولُوا. So we know that when we say لَا تَقُولُوا, do not say, يعني أَنْتُمْ تَقُولُوا. So there is fail plus file. And al-haqqa will be maf'ul bihi, that's why it is mansub. All right, number two. وَلَا يَلْتَفِتْ مِنْكُمْ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا امْرَأَتَكْ. Okay. Again, is it mujab or غَيْرُ mujab? غَيْرُ mujab. Okay. And we know what, whenever kalam is غَيْرُ mujab, we know that يَجُوزُ نَصْبُهُ, then it's possible that it can be mansub, and we know that it can be marfu'. So وَلَا يَلْتَفِتْ مِنْكُمْ أَحَدٌ. So is it تَامٌ or مُفَرَّغٌ?
تَامٌ.
تَامٌ, excellent. وَلَا يَلْتَفِتْ مِنْكُمْ أَحَدٌ, because أَحَدٌ is mentioned over here. So when we know that whenever مُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ is mentioned, then it will be تَامٌ. So it is تَامٌ مُتَّسِلٌ, but غَيْرُ مُوجَب. It is غَيْرُ مُوجَب, because again we can see that there is prohibition. So whenever we have غَيْرُ مُوجَب, whenever the speech is تَامٌ مُتَّسِلٌ غَيْرُ مُوجَب, then it has to be, it can be مَرْفُو and it can be مَنْسُوب. And we know that whenever it is مَنْسُوب, we know that يَجُوزُ نَصْبُهُ, then it's possible for it to be مَنْسُوب. And we know that إِمْرَأَتَكْ, over here it is مَنْسُوب. And why? Because يَجُوزُ نَصْبُهُ. And let not among you look back except your wife. Let not, as we can see that this is prohibition. So here it is غَيْرُ مُوجَب, and here also it is غَيْرُ مُوجَب. وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. And who can forgive sins except Allah? All right, so is it تَامًا or مَفَرَّغٌ? وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا
اللَّهِ. It is
مُفَرَّغٌ. مُفَرَّغٌ, أحسنتي. Yes, it's مُفَرَّغٌ. And we know that whenever it is مُفَرَّغٌ, then what we should do is basically we remove, or we say as if illa does not exist. And this is only for our own understanding. So as if illa does not exist, so يَغْفِرُ is the verb, and it needs the doer, or it needs the fa'il, and لَفْتَ الْجَلَالَ is the fa'il. So that's why it is مَرْفُو. So it's مُفَرَّغٌ مَرْفُوٌ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ فَعِلٌ. So as we know that here, اسم الجلالة is the doer, and that's why it will be مرفوع. So I hope inshallah it's clear over here. And we know that مفرغ, we know that whenever we are doing the, you know, like إعراب for مفرغ, we can only do it by removing illa, again illa, as if it does not exist, but only for the purpose of learning, and not, we can't really remove it, I mean, in reality. Then we have the next one, and who can forgive sins except Allah? وَقَدَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. Okay. And your Lord has decreed that you worship not except Him. وَقَدَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ. So إِيَّاهُ is mansub. Also it's مُفَرَّغ, because مُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ is not mentioned. وقضى ربك and منصوب على انه مفعول به ياهو here is مفعول به لا تعبد الا it's basically ان لا and because of the rules of the tajweed it becomes الله تعبد so this is لا النهي that you do not worship الا except ياهو and we know that ياهو this is the ضمير of منصوب or it's the ضمير of نصب whenever we have ايا إياه إياهما إياهم إياك إياكما إياكنا up to إيانا it is always the ضمير of منصوب it cannot be مرفوع so that's why here it is منصوب and then the next one is وما يهلكنا إلا الدهر and nothing destroys us except time again مستثنى منه is not mentioned yeah okay excellent so it's مفرغ and why it is مرفوع مرفوع على أنه فاعل الدهر is the doer and يهلكو as we can see is the فاعل now will be مفعول به so يهلكو is the verb and الدهر will be the فاعل so وما يهلكنا إلا الدهر and again we can see that this is غير موجب and غير موجب as we know غير موجب can be مرفوع and it can also be منصوب so there are two possibilities so here we will say Because it is mufarrag, that's why it's easier to understand when it is mufarrag, because we remove illa, and then after that we can see that here ad-dahru is dur or it is marfu. That's why the ending of ad-dahru is dhamma or it is marfu. فَإِنَّهُمْ عَدُوٌ لِي إِلَّا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ Okay, what about this one? Indeed, they are enemies to me except the Lord of the worlds.
This is
munqati'un. Excellent. Yes, yeah, munqati'un. Perfect. And when we know that whenever it is munqati'un, then it has to be mansub. It's wajib that we have to make it mansub. So wujubun nasbi. So that's why we can see that Rabb al-alamin. Rabb is basically over here. It is mansub mm-hmm. and it is mudaf and al-alamin is mudaf ilayh. Indeed, they are enemies to me except the Lord of the worlds. So alhamdulillah. We are able to understand the verses of the Quran and also about illa. We know that it's been a little bit like harder than the rest of the rules and it needed a little bit more effort. But alhamdulillah, with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have been able to analyze the verses of the Quran. And then we have a little bit more practice, inshallah. And this practice is going to be easier now. أمام كل جملة مما يأتي اسم In front of each sentence, there is a noun. اجعله مستثنى بإلا Then we have to make istathna using illa wa akmil bihil jumlata and then we have to complete the sentence. Okay, the first one we will analyze it all the way and inshallah the rest of the sentences will be based on the same pattern so it will be easier for us to figure out the mustathna. يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ الذُّنُوبَ كُلَّهَا إِلَّا So what should be here? Ash-shirku or ash-shirka?
Ash-shirka because it is
down. Excellent, because al-dhunub is mustathna and mustathna minhu and ash-shirk is dhamb. So it is tamun. We can see that it's tamun, it's muttasilun, dhamb and shirk are muttasilun and also it is mujabun. So all the three conditions have been met and we know that whenever all the three conditions have been met, then mustathna is always mansub. And now I can drop you a hint that the rest of the sentences will be based on the same pattern. Zarani jami'u zumala'i illa
isnaini.
Illa thnaini, excellent. So zarani jami'u zumala'i, all of my classmates visited me. Illa thnaini except for two. So we can see the illa thnaini except for two. And the idea is the same as we have discussed in the first example, and as I said, that the rest of the sentences will be based on the same pattern. نجح الطلاب كلهم إلا المتأخرين. متأخرين, excellent. All the students succeeded except for the latecomers. And the same thing as we can see that الطلاب, and we know كلهم is used for emphasis, and المتأخرين, it's the students who are late, so it's تامون متصلون. And also it is mujabun, and that's why it is wujubun nasbi. It has to be mansub. Hafidh al-Qur'ana illa surah?
Taini.
Taini, excellent. I memorized the whole Quran except for the two surahs. And again, the idea is the same, that the surahs, they are the part of the Quran. So it is muttasilun, also it is tamun, and it is mujabun. Okay, next is Zurtul Bilad al Islamiyata kullaha illa
Pakistana.
I visited all the Islamic countries except for Pakistan. So now we can see that Al Bilad al Islamiyya, Islamic countries, and also Pakistan is Islamic Republic of Pakistan. So it's a part of all Islamic countries, as we can see over here. So that's why all the conditions, all the three conditions have been met. And that's why Al Mustathna is Mansub. Sa'adani jamiu zumala'i illa. Now I want to test your knowledge. All the classmates helped me except for you.
Iyaka.
Excellent. Illa Iyaka. Because as we have discussed earlier, that anta is the pronoun, and it is in the place of the doer. So this is subject pronoun. But when we say Iyaka, Iyaka will be the object pronoun. And here we have to have the noun that is object, or the pronoun that is object. Okay. فهمت المسائل النحوية كلها. This is my favorite sentence. إلا الاستثناء. I understood all the grammatical rules except for exception. إلا الاستثناء. So alhamdulillah, we did understand استثناء, but as we discussed in the beginning of the lesson, that استثناء is slightly difficult as compared to the other rules. Yeah. So فهمت المسائل النحوية كلها إلا الاستثناء. And here, how would you analyze it? Please give me the analysis so that we know استثناء, inshallah.
مسائل النحوية is all of their the rules of this thing, right?
Of the grammar, yes. Yeah. And استثناء is also the rule of the grammar. Excellent. So that means they are متصلون, they are a part of one another or each other, right? And then the sentence is موجب or غير موجب. Positive, or it's mujib, it's positive. And also tamun, as we know, that mustathna minhu is mentioned. So all the three conditions have been met. So that means, inshallah, our istithna is clear now. Qara'atul kitaba kullahu illa
safahatin.
Excellent. Safahatin, yeah. Atun, atin, atin. This is also slightly confusing. We know that whenever we talk about feminine sound plural, the marfu will be atun, and mansub and majroor will be atin, atin. And here it has to be mansub, it will be atin. Qara'atul kitaba kullahu illa safahatin minhu. I read the whole book except for a few pages from it. Amama kulli jumlatin mimma yati ismun. The same idea, the same text, I mean. Ij'alhu mustathna bi illa wa akmil bihil jumlata. And now we have to complete the sentences using illa. Okay,
when?
Now if you look here, we have ma, lam, la, hal, and ma. So that means all of them are ghayru mujib, right? So if all the sentences, we can see that all of them are ghayru mujib, that means now there are two possibilities. Yeah, that mustathna can be, it can be mansub, and it can be according to whatever we have in the sentence, right? So it can be, there are two possibilities. Number one, it will be mansub. Mustathna will be mansub. And number two, it will be the badal of whatever we have over here. So ma rasaba ahadun illa. No one failed except for Khalid. Yeah. So now Khalid can have two case endings. It can be mansub, Khalidan. And it can be marfu, Khalidun. Why it is marfu? Because it is badal from ahadun. And we know that Badal has the same Arab as Mubdal Minhu. So Ahadun is Marfu and Khalidun is Marfu. And the second possibility is when Kalam is Ghayru Mujab, then it can also be Mansub. So there are two possibilities, and both of them are clear now. Ma akaltu shayyan illa, except for two dates. I didn't eat anything except for two dates. Illa. Okay, so there are two possibilities. So what should be the two possibilities over here?
Tamrataini.
Tamrataini. Okay, so twice it will be tamrataini. Okay, why twice? It has to be tamrataini. number one, it has to be mansub, right? So that's fine. And number two, now we can see that shay'an is mansub. And from shay'an, tamrataini is badal. It's badal. So badal is always, as we can see, it carries the same irab as it has the irab of mubdal minhu. So shay'an is mansub and tamrataini is also mansub. I hope it's clear now. So the first possibility is that it's badal. And the second possibility is that it has to be or it can be mansub. لَمْ يُسَافِرُ الطُّلَّابُ فِي أُطْلَةِ الرَّبِيعِ إِلَّا بَعْضَهُمْ and بَعْضُهُمْ, right? So بَعْضُهُمْ and بَعْضُهُمْ, both of them are there. So بَعْضُهُمْ will be the badal of طُلَّابُ and بَعْضَهُمْ is the second possibility that it can also be mansub. لَا تَتَّصِلْ بِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا الْمُدِيرَ الْمُدِيرَ وَإِلَّا الْمُدِيرِ, right? Two possibilities will be there. Al-Mudiri, why it is majroor? Because it is the badal of ahadin. Excellent. And the second possibility, we know that it can be mansub. هَلْ يَغْفِرَ الذُّنُوبَ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا اللَّهِ?
It can be.
أَحَدٌ. Yeah, so it can be. There are two possibilities again. So it can be إِلَّاللَّهُ and it can be إِلَّاللَّهَ. Similarly, we have لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. And also it can be la ilaha illallah. Both possibilities are there in kalima. But you know, like as the grammarians, they say that marfu is like it's afsahu min mansub. So it's like more like, as we can say, yes?
More preferable.
Yes, more preferable. So that's why. And that's why in kalima we have la ilaha illallah. However, if it is like la ilaha illallah, also, that will be grammatically correct. ما سألت أحدا إلا
إياه.
إلا إياه. Okay. So إياه will come how many times?
أحدا إياه إياه.
Okay, twice. Perfect. So number one, it is إياه because it is mansub, and number two, it is badal from أحدا. Okay, and similarly here, it is badal over here. Is there, inshallah, clear? Mm-hmm. All right. أمام كل جملة مما يأتي اسما اجعله مستثنى بإلا واكمل به الجملة. Okay, so here, what do you think could happen over here? Again, we have ما, yeah. Mm-hmm. So most likely it will be the same idea as we have seen earlier. So let's do, but there are some possibilities are there that if the kalam is tam or ghayru tam, then we have to go according to the case endings. So we will see that in number 7, most of the sentences, or we can say like, majority of the sentences are mufarrag. They are mufarrag. And what do you remember about mufarrag? What should be the case endings?
Mansub.
Mufarrag is mansub. Are you sure? As if illa does not exist.
Yeah,
the illa. As if illa does not exist.
It depends
okay?
on the position of the sentence as well.
Yeah, because we know that all of the sentences are ghayru mujab, but the thing is, they are mufarrag. If you look at the sentences, we will see, like, why do we say mufarrag? Because mustathna minhu is not mentioned. Yeah, so ma fahima darsa illa. So what we have to do, just to, for the sake of learning grammar, we will see as if illa does not exist. So ma fahima darsa illa.
Ibrahim.
No one understood the lesson except for Ibrahim. And if Ibrahim is the doer of the action, so what will be the ending of Ibrahim?
Ibrahimu.
Yeah. So fahima is fa'il, Ibrahimu is fa'il, and adars is. Again, we have to remove illa and we have to look for the doer of the action. Yes, excellent. So it will be asayiqu, because if you remove illa, ma mata, no one died, ma mata, and we can see that mata is the verb, and then the doer of the action will be asayiqu, and fil hadith is jar majrur, so it will be marfu, right? Ma mata fil hadithi illa asayiqu, no one died in the accident except for the driver. Ma yuhibbu al-mudarrisu illa. The teacher doesn't like anyone except for the hardworking student. Illa al
mujtahidu only.
La yuhibbu fa'il al-mudarrisu fa'il for the best student or the hardworking student. Hal yarsubu illa
al-kaslanu.
Yeah, the doer of the action. Hal yarsubu illa al-kaslanu. Will anyone fail except for the lazy one? Or does anyone fail except for the lazy one? Then we have ma akaltu illa burtaqala taini. Akaltu is fail. Akaltu is fail plus fail, and burtaqala taini will be maful bihi. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to remove illa because it is mufarrag. Then we have ma sa'ala al mudarrisu illa. Excellent. Illa iyaya. And when you stop, you will say illa iyai. It will be illa iyai. Iyai. Illa iyaya. Okay. And then we have ma kuntu illa.
Mudarrisan.
Mudarrisan, yes. Because kuntu is fail plus fail. Or in fact, we know that kana has ismu kana and khabru kana. So, ta, as we can see, is ismu kana. And we know that and khabru kana will always be mansub. So, this is also, alhamdulillah, easier. And we are able to figure out most of the ideas in this exercise as well. So, let's move on to the next exercise. Amama kulli jumlatin fi ma ya'ti isman. Ij'alhu mustathnan bi illa wa akmil bihi al-jumlata. So, that's the same thing. We have to complete the sentences by using illa. Okay, do you want me to drop your hint or you would like to figure out by yourselves? Illa al-unwana. Is there any connection between risala and unwan?
The kind.
Nan
is the
Munqatiyun. So here we have the examples of munqatiyun. Munqatiyun means they are not from the same jins. They are not from the same jins. Okay. So risala is like it's a letter, and then unwan is the address. So two different things. They are disconnected. Munqatiyun. So that's why we know that the ending of munqatiyun is always. Do you remember? Munqatiyun is always.
Mansub.
Yeah, that's why in the beginning of the lesson we had a bit of review so that we remember everything. So katabtu risalata illa al-ulwana. I wrote the message except for the address. Ma yatanawalu al-maridu at-ta'ama illa
ad-dawa'a.
So we know that we can see that ta'am and dawa, they are two different things, right? So kalam is munqati'un, so that's why it will be mansub. Ma yatanawalu al-maridu at-ta'ama illa ad-dawa'a. The patient did not eat any kind of food except for the medicine. He didn't eat food, but he took the medicine. So we know that there is no connection between food and medicine. And as we, when we talk about the jinns, I mean, yeah. So it's not badul kalam, yani dawa is not a part of the food, right? Ghadar al-hujaju mina illa ash-shurtata. So all the pilgrims left Mina when they go for Hajj, except for the policeman. Illa ash-shurtata, right? Ash-shurtata, because Hujjaj and Shurta, they are munqati'un, yeah, they are disconnected. Ma ahdartu al-kutuba illa
ad-dafatira.
Ad-dafatira, excellent. So books and notebooks, they are different, so that's why it's munqati'un. And whenever the speech is munqati'un, then it has to be mansub. Ma mata ar-rukkabu fil hadithi illa al-mushata, right? Illa al-mushat. No passengers died in the accident except for the pedestrians. Pedestrians, we have learned that the mashin is masha yamshi fahuwa mashin, and the plural of mashin will be mushatun. So mushatun is used for pedestrians. Al-Isharatu al-Mushatu, the signal that we see on the like road. So it's called pedestrian crossing. And then there is a signal, they press on that signal and then they pass the road. So that's the plural of mashin is mushatun. Ma mata rukabu fil hadithi illa al-mushata. No passengers died in the accident except for the pedestrians. Now we know that rukab and pedestrians are different. It's munqatiun. It's munqatiun because generally the passengers are in any kind of vehicle, whereas the pedestrians are walking. So there is no connection. So that's why it is munqatiun, and that's why it is mansub. I believe it's the last one over here, and this is our test, real test for all of us. أكمل كل جملة مما يأتي بمستثنى مناسب. Now we have to complete the sentences by using a suitable مستثنى. Okay, ما ظننتك إلا. I don't see you, but إلا. We can say مدرسا طبيبا طالبا, right? So I don't see you, or I don't assume, or I don't assume you. Other than a doctor. So ma zanantuka illa tabiban. So what kind of sentence is this? Mujab or ghayru mujab? Ghayru mujab. And we know that when we have ghayru mujab, then it's possible for it to be mansub, and also it's possible to be marfu. However, mustathna minhu is mentioned or not?
It's not mentioned.
Yeah, so that's why it has to be mansub, because it is munqatiun, right? The speech or the sentence can be tamun, tamun muttasilun, and it can be tamun munqatiun, right? So here it's not tamun, it is tamun, sorry, but it's munqatiun, it's not connected. Mustathna minhu is not from the same family as it is supposed to be. So because we know that ka and tabib, they are completely different. Uhibbu al-fawakiha kullaha illa الموزة التفاحة العنبة. So when you say, let's say التفاحة, now here why it is mansub?
It's one of the nine, so it should be متصلون موجبون and تامون.
أحسنتي. All the three conditions have been met. تامون متصلون وموجبون. Very good. ما رسب الطلاب إلا بلالا زيدا عمارا Saliman.
The same irab of tulab.
Excellent. So it could be badal from tulab, and it also it can be mansub because it is ghayru mujab and mustathna minhu is connected. So that's the difference between muttasilun and munqatiun. In muttasilun, the mustathna minhu is the same jins as al mustathna. So al mustathna, sorry, is the same jins as mustathna minhu. But when we talk about munqatiun, then mustathna is different from mustathna minhu. They are completely different. Ma ghaba al-yawma illa Ibrahim. Okay, any name there. Zaidun, Muhammadun, Bilalun. So what should I say? Bilalun or Bilalan or Bilalin?
Bilalan.
So it should be five.
Bilalun, excellent. Why? Because it is it's mufarrag, right? We don't have mustathna minhu. Do we have mustathna minhu over here?
No, sir.
So that's why it's munqatiun. So that's why it has to be. Sorry, it is mufarrag. So that's why it will be bilalun. Ma arghabu fi shayin illa. The example that the Sheikh has given over here, he mentioned two over here is az-zawaj, az-zawaji wa az-zawaja. I'm not interested in anything else except for marriage. So here, az-zawaji and az-zawaja, why we have two case endings?
Fi shay'in, the shay is this one.
Badal, okay. Yeah, shay'in and az-zawaj, they are badal. And here, az-zawaja, it's ghayru mujab, so it can be also mansub. Excellent. Ma katabtu shay'in illa ar-risalata. I didn't write anything else except for the message. And we have seen this example in the previous exercise as well, because they are not connected, they are munqatiun. And we know that munqatiun is always mansub, as we can see over here. All right. So alhamdulillah, our journey of illa or exception has come to an end over here. However, it has come to an end only in this lesson. And when we talk about the Quran and the rest of the Arabic, that means our journey has just started. Yeah. Okay. Here we have ala kullu shay'in, ala harfu istiftahin wa tanbihin. So ala is basically a letter of beginning and also a letter of drawing someone's attention. Nahu ala innahum humusufaha. Ala means beware. Also, unquestionably, it's translated in different ways. And we know that this is basically harfu istiftah that is used, that comes in the beginning of the sentence. And why does it come? To draw the attention of the listener. Ala innahum humusufaha. Unquestionably, it is they who are the foolish, but they do not know it. We don't have this part, so only this up to here. Ala innahum humusufaha'u. Unquestionably, it is they who are the foolish. And we know, we can see over here, this is hum over here is the mirul fasl. Ala inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. Again, in the Sahih International, it has been translated as unquestionably. But again, as you said, there are different translations and they translate halla, right? Halla, which is used for tandeem and also for like tawdih. So for two reasons, like when you're encouraging tahdeed and tandeem, right? We have learned about halla and now we are learning about Allah. Similarly, we have in the Quran like kalla, and similarly we have Allah, and here we have learned Allah and also Halla, we have seen in the previous lesson. So this is just one of the things that we learn about in this lesson. Then we have Hati Jam' al Asma' al Atiyati. We have to provide the plural of the following nouns. Dinarun. Yes, does anyone know the meaning, the plural of dinar? It will be Dananiru. Dananiru. Mafa'ilu. It's on the pattern of Mafa'ilu. Dirhamun. It's on the pattern of mafa'ilu. So it will be darahimu.
Darahim.
And we know these are the currencies that are used. Abdun. And the plural will be? Ibadun. Ibadun that we in the prayer every day when we recite at the shahud. So we say, As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi s-salihin. Yeah, so ibadun. Then we have amatun, that is used for the female slave. And the plural is ima'un. Amatun, ima'un. Silahun, weapon. And the plural will be aslihatun. Aslihatun, okay. Very good. Then we have sharhun, masdaru sharha yashrahu, wa huwa ala wazni fi'lin. So we can see that sharhun is on the pattern of fi'lun. So we have the verbs over here, and now we have to provide their masdar on the same pattern, which is fi'lun. So daraba will be darbun. Qatala will be
qatlun.
Fataha will be fathun. And shaqqa will be shaq. Excellent. And then after that, you have to use the rules of the idgham, so it will be shaqqun. Because you know, whenever we have the two letters, they are the same, and then what happens, there is a tashdeed, and after tashdeed we merge them, so it becomes, it was originally shaqqun, and then it becomes shaqqun, which is to crack something. Ma ma'na al-amati wa ma jam'uha. I've just provided the meaning of al-amati and the plural a while ago. So do you remember?
Imaun, something like that.
Excellent, yeah. And what's the meaning? Do you remember the meaning?
The slave, the female slave.
Female slave, excellent. So it manaha al-mar'atul mamlukatu mar'a, right? We know that it's imra'atun, and whenever we use al with that, then it will be read as al-mar'atu. Al-mar'atul mamlukatu wa jam'uha ima'un. Female slave, the one who has been owned by someone else, and its plural is ima'un.
It says, no, Ustad, this one, ayah, wa yawma yashaqqaqul ardu. This one, that one you said, the shaqqaqa is the cleaving, yes, of the...
Yes, yes, the cleaving or the cracking of... Idha samaa'un shaqqat wa aydinat li rabbiha wa huqqat, yeah? So yeah. That's the verb, something that cracks or cleavage, as you said. Dinar, jam'uhu, dananiru. The plural of dinar is dananiru. Ala ghayri qiyasin. But it's not on qiyas, it's not on the analogy that we use, or the wazan, or the pattern that we use, or we can say it's not on the same measure as it should be. Idhal qiyasu an yakuna diyaniru. When we talk about the qiyas, yani it, the plural should be diyaniru, because it is dinar, right? So we have dal and then we have ya after that. So if you want to put it on the pattern of mafa'ilu, it will be diyaniru. But what happened over here? It is ghayru, yani it's ala ghayri qiyasin, that it is a different kind of pattern that we can see over here. And it can happen in the Arabic language. It's not always the case, but there is a possibility that the plural, the pattern, we know in the pattern, we know that the vowel signs will be the same. For example, it will be mafa'ilu, right? So the vowel signs will be the same. But generally, the root letters do not change. The root letters do not change. But here we can see that the root letter also has changed. So instead of dayanir, it is dananir. So ya has been changed with na. And that's as we know, the beauty of the Arabic language. I think nothing else that we can say about it. Now, ijma'il asma'il atiyata hadal jam'a. Diwan. So diwanu will be on the same pattern. So it will be dawawinu. Yeah, collection of poems. Dawawinu. Perfect. Qirat, as we say in gold, carat. So it will be?
Qaratitu.
Okay. Qararitu. It will be qararitu. Dimas is used for dungeon or any kind of prison that's generally inside a building. So dimas will be? Damamisu. Damamisu. Oh, okay. All right. So, yes. Sorry?
Word has to be repeated. Ustad. Instead of ya, we are taking the same word and repeating.
Yes. So that's the only small change that takes place. And that's, as I said, that doesn't follow the qiyas, but it's not like always the case. There are very few cases that we can see over here that can happen over here. And this number 15, question number 15. Akhsha an akuna iyahu. I'm afraid I'm that student or I'm that one. Idha kana khabaru kana. So if the khabar of kana is idha kana khabaru kana dhamiran, so if the khabar of kana is a dhamir or if it's a pronoun, yajuzu fihi al-ittisalu, then it's possible to connect it. Wal infisalu, and also it's possible to disconnect it. Yani to put it together and also to not to put it together. Fayajuzu an naqula akhsha an akunahu. It's also possible to say that I am that student. So we can say akhsha an akuna iyyahu, and also it's possible to say akhsha an akunahu. And that's the only possibility when khabaru kana is a pronoun, when it is damir. No other possibility, just one possibility, when khabaru kana is a pronoun. Ha'a mithalaini akharaini. Here are two other examples. Akunta imam hadha al-masjidi, were you the imam of this masjid? Na'am kuntu iyyahu wa kuntu hu. So I was that person and I was the imam of that masjid and I was that person kuntu hu. So there are two possibilities. We can say kuntu iyyahu and we can also say kuntu hu. Aturidu an takuna mudarrisan, do you want to be a teacher? La ma uridu an akuna iyyahu, or we can say an akunahu. I don't want to be a teacher, and also we can say iyahu, and also we can say akunahu. We have seen like kana has lots of uses in the Quran, lots of different possibilities. Different tenses are used when we talk about kana, and here we have something different as well. And this is special to kana as well, that whenever khabaru kana is a pronoun, it's a damir, then there are two possibilities, that we can have the detached pronoun and we can also have the attached pronoun as khabaru kana. So alhamdulillah, finally our lesson has come to an end. So as we know that inna ma'al usri yusra, or inna ma'al usri yusra, as we can say. So there is always, inshallah, ease after difficulty. So inshallah, I believe that we have been through that phase, and now whatever inshallah comes will be easier for us to understand and to implement. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك واتوب اليك. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.
جزاك الله خير.